Say, you guys remember that crazy Ferngully cartoon? Talk about obscure, right? Well, that's why it's perfect for an episode of Have You Ever Heard Of? What do you mean it's been done? I used to watch this movie all the time as a kid. Tim Curry voiced the bad guy, Robin Williams was the bat, and he raps. Rockin' I ramble, my brain is scrambled, rap like an animal, but I'm a mammal. There's a lot of material to work with here. Okay, fine. What about Cats Don't Dance? I mean, what kind of title is that? Cats Don't Dance. I mean, haven't they ever heard of the internet?
Cats? I'm a kitty cat. Cats? I'm a kitty cat.
This movie too, huh? Well, then the Mario Brothers movie. Thumbelina? The secret of, oh, come on! Well, I guess the internet's been around for long enough that nothing's obscure anymore. I could look up any dumb movie I watched as a kid, and there'll be dozens of chuckle fucks out there who've done a video on it already. But, as a wise man once said, fuck it. Don Bluth, the internet's favorite lesser-known animator. Actually, Ralph Bakshi's been starting to take over that title lately, but that's another video for another time. Like many others, I grew up with Don Bluth's movies, and this happens to be the one that stuck with me the most. Can't fathom why, though. So, let's take a look at this blast from the past. Almost a decade after everyone else has. That's apparently how I roll. Pebble and the Penguin is about the mating habits of the Adélie penguins in Antarctica, where during the ritual, male penguins give female penguins a smooth stone as a gift to help build their nest. What I couldn't find while searching the internet, though, was that they also wear human clothes and dance around to Barry Manilow music. So the story starts with a Disney-style storybook opening. Yeah, isn't that a trip, coming from the poor man's Disney? He pulled the same thing with Thumbelina, too. Actually, while making this video, I learned that Don Bluth did work with Disney during the making of Robin Hood and Winnie the Pooh, so I guess it's not that crazy. Anyway, the movie then goes into this opening number that basically paints the penguin mating ritual as some kind of high school pink ladies and pea birds kind of dynamic. Pea birds, get it? Cuddle and coo and kiss? I mean, shouldn't it be cuddle and coo and screw? I mean, at least it rhymes. We're introduced to Marina, the love interest of our main protagonist, Hubie, and how she doesn't care about Pebbles and just wants to meet the right penguin. Which, spoilers, is apparently Hubie. Problem is, Hubie's really shy and voiced by Martin Short, so his prospects of mating are rather slim. We learn all this with this conversation with the exposition birds, who seem awfully familiar.
Tell us a story.
Yes, a love story.
Oh, that's mushy stuff.
Well, usually the hero gives his fair lady a kiss.
A kiss? Oh, that's sissy stuff.
And then bam, Hubie bumps into Marina, who I guess was just standing there.
Marina!
So, it wasn't an avalanche. That was some landing, Hubie.
Well, they seem to be hitting it off pretty well, and yet we still have about an hour left in this movie. Yeah, I guess we still have to be introduced to the villain, whose name is Drake, a weirdly deformed penguin voiced by Tim Curry doing his best surfer dude impression.
My children will be the strongest, the smartest, the bravest, not to mention the best looking. What? They'll be just like me!
it's not great.
This is quite a spot, Hubie. What do you do up here?
I furiously masturbate. Speaking of masturbation, how about more Manilow?
Why the sea is green like your eyes.
not the same color.
Oh, no. I don't think it's nonsense at all. Even if you are a bit wacky.
And colorblind, but whatever. Now that, Hubie, is what we call a sure thing. Oh, right. I guess he still has to get a pebble to give her. But we can guess how well that's gonna go.
With the day almost done, and the beach picked clean of the best engagement stones, how could he ever hope to find the perfect pebble for his perfect love, Marina?
Man, if only picking the perfect pebble wasn't so important to Marina. Oh, wait.
No, you know, I don't think a pebble should be that important, Marina.
Anyway, a stone falls from the sky and bada bing, the perfect pebble. Just keep it away from Superman. But of course, dude bro Drake wants to take the pebble away from Hubie.
Zeus, nerd. I hear you want to be a big ladies' man.
And when Hubie refuses, he throws him in the ocean. How terrible. All is not well, though, as a leopard seal shows up. Aw, but leopard seals are so cute, though. They can't be bad guys. Oh, Jesus, I take it back. So Hubie is set adrift on an iceberg.
Where there lived an enemy even greater than the leopard seal. Man.
Ouch, narrator. That hurts. We're not all bad, you know. Hubie is taken prisoner on a ship called Misery. Well, at least we know the captain has a sense of humor. Where he meets other penguins, who then, of course, begin to sing.
Then we all get good and miserable.
And, I mean, the song's kinda catchy. Honestly, this whole bit is animation at its finest. I mean, just watching it is making me feel genuinely seasick. Speaking of great animation, check out the penguins frozen in the background. After that, Misery. The penguin form of Jim Belushi gets introduced, and we learn that the penguins are being shipped off to zoos.
But I've heard stories of sailors selling penguins to zoos.
Zoos?
Zoos? I'm not going to no zoo, no, no!
This infuriates Rocco, the Jim Belushi penguin, and he starts working on a way out while Hubie starts seeing things in his pebble. Apparently the pebble can do that. So Marina is being pressured by Drake to marry him, which Marina refuses.
You must choose a mate before the full moon mating ceremony, or be banished. Gosh, that's the law.
A law approved by Penguin Congress, I assume. Seriously, what a weird thing for a penguin wearing a cape to say. And no, I haven't gotten over the fact that he's wearing a cape. So Hubie, after seeing what I guess wasn't just hallucination, asks to join Rocco on his escape, who is hesitant to let him join.
Forget it.
But a moment ago you asked who's for busting out of here. Well, I am.
You're too dumb.
But not hesitant to tell it like it is. Hubie eventually convinces Rocco, and we see Rocco's grand scheme in action.
Yeah!
Okay, grand was probably not the word to use. So after more dramatics and Don Bluth's patented busy as hell animation, the two swim away from the ship, where they make landfall on a postcard of a beach.
We must be in Moorea or Tahiti.
How do they live like this?
They pay for it.
We get a recap of Hubie's dumb love story, and we learn of what Rocco's big dream is.
You're looking at it.
I'm looking at...
Yep. Rocco wants to take a shit on everything. No, Rocco wants to learn how to fly, which Hubie finds hilarious.
I mean, you've gotta just accept it.
No! No! I don't accept nothing!
But, Rocco, that's the way things are!
Yeah, what a ridiculous dream. I mean, it's not like you're fighting against the odds, Hubie. Oh, and Hubie also lies to Rocco about a flying penguin he knows named Waldo.
Waldo?
That's who?
Waldo?
Yeah, he's...
Who's Waldo?
Waldo is this short little penguin back in my rooker.
In order to trick Rocco into coming with him back to Antarctica.
Can we swim as we talk? Marina's waiting.
Yeah, sure, why not? I got a couple of days anyway.
Hubie's kind of an asshole. Meanwhile, at Castle Grayskull, Drake is busy chewing on bones. Odd considering penguins don't have teeth. I mean, well, they're not supposed to anyway. And these bones don't even look like they belong to any fish. Anyone else find this odd, or am I looking too far into a stupid kids movie again? You know, I'm guessing some of these bones probably belong to whoever he stole that cape from. Back to Rocco and Hubie, where they stop on a rocky island so that Rocco can attempt to fly.
What? I'm flying! I'm flying! Yes! Yes!
Oh my god, what a shock, it didn't work. He should definitely take some lessons from Wilbur. After that, the two find themselves unable to leave the island due to nature's greatest killer. Oh wait, I forgot. I'm nature's greatest killer, according to this movie and every other animal movie. Oh, I was too busy talking and missed why Hubie and Rocco were fighting with each other.
Well then, fine.
Fine is right.
When the whale leaves, we'll just go our separate ways then.
Yeah, it probably wasn't important. And then a storm hits. Man, that lightning is out for blood. Screw killer whales, lightning is a penguin's mortal enemy. Meanwhile, at the Fortress of Solitude, Drake hasn't gotten a bad guy song yet. Now, what would be a suitable genre of music for an evil penguin that talks like a surfer and is voiced by Tim Curry? If you guessed tango, then that's not fair. You've probably seen this movie before.
Hey, yes, my love, and go with a winner.
I mean, I guess the tango works. I was just hoping it would be death metal. Well, that was a thing. Has Hubie gotten back home yet? No, he has to make amends with Rocco first. Well, let's hurry this up.
Rocco, there's something you should know. Waldo isn't real.
No, Hubie, don't do it. You're just gonna keep the plot going longer.
Rocco, stop!
I could have been back in Tahiti with those people on the beach.
Oh man, now they have to make up again. Oh, and Waldo does exist. See, look. He's right there. The two eventually make up when...
Come here!
I don't get it. So now they're friends again. Meanwhile, back at Narnia.
Sometimes I close my eyes.
Marina gets a song.
If you're still alive, how could you?
Man, screw Where's Waldo? Where the heck is Wolf's Tail? Does not exist. Back to Rocco and Hubie, and they still haven't made it back yet? No, I guess they have to go fishing, which is an interesting sequence where you don't get any dialogue, thank Christ, and instead just have music to go with the action. I know young me probably found this shit boring, but I don't know, it's kinda neat. And of course they run into another ugly seal. Looks like he may have been kissed too hard by a rose, if you know what I'm saying. The two escape, but for some reason, the near-death experience gives Rocco a hard-on for Hubie.
You are amazing!
Amazing?
This makes Hubie happy and...
Knew it all along!
Get away from me!
Oh no, is that jaunty music playing?
Look how we get along together.
Oh come on, not again!
Incredibly annoying.
And our brave hero forces Rocco to say he likes him by holding his breath like a child.
I kinda, sorta, maybe, you know.
You mean you like me?
What a stand-up guy I'm supposed to be rooting for. Also, for a creature that can swim, it didn't take too long for him to start going blue from holding his breath.
We really showed him!
We showed him? We? Aw, come on, you're a terrible fighter!
Oh, that's the end of that scene, I guess. Now there's just a matter of that killer whale that was hinted at earlier.
My pebble!
Pebble, your pebble! Forget about the blasted pebble!
Yeah, I'm with Rocco. The pebble shouldn't even be an issue anymore. Marina won't freaking shut up about Hubie back home. It's a done deal. No need for it. though it was nice enough to land so delicately on the sunken boat. Once again, the killer whales being the bad guys means that they're scary as all hell. Man, killer whales are super cute too. I don't care if they eat other cute things. Quit reminding me of that movie. Yeah, Free Willy joke. After the smoke clears, or rather, the tide goes down, we get the tropey think someone's dead because an article of their clothing came out of the water, but they didn't bit. Yeah, we're gonna miss him for the next 2 minutes. Then the exposition birds show back up. Yeah, remember them from the beginning? They're here to let the audience know that Drake is taking Marina to a sex dungeon.
Get your filthy flippers off my girl!
But Hubie shows up and is ready to rumble.
We thought you were dead!
You heard me, Drake!
Now you're gonna wish that you were.
Damn, Drake has quite the bosoms on him. No one dies like Gaston, except for Drake, apparently.
I'm sorry.
Oh, Marina.
I found another, and his name is Rocco.
Will you be my mate?
Hey, wait a second. Hubie doesn't even use the damn pebble when he asks Marina to be his mate. Like I was saying all along, the pebble was useless. It wasn't a MacGuffin for his puffin, it was a red herring. And I'm not talking about fish. Speaking of Rocco, he's alive, to no one's surprise. And so is Drake. Okay, that one kind of surprised me. But he's not back for very long. Jesus. With Drake's lair falling apart, Marina and Hubie begin to fall to their deaths. Whatever will Rocco do?
Next time to fly.
Yep, Rocco can suddenly fly without even using his wings. Now, hold on, let's think about this. The pebble came from outer space and gave Hubie visions. Then, after making it back safely home due to defying the laws of nature, Rocco has it. It all makes sense now. The pebble is pure uranium! These are mutant penguins suffering from radiation poisoning! Their beaks are gonna rot and turn purple! Their kids are gonna be born with 3 dicks! Either that, or it's magic. I don't fucking know.
I love you even more.
Yay! Yeah! And so, Hubie and Marina start mating right then and there, in front of all the other penguins. Rocco becomes frozen in terror. And that's The Pebble and the Penguin, which, like every other damn kids movie, ends with a shitty pop version of the main theme.
One perfect moment, just one humble stone.
You know, what all kids love listening to. Oh yeah, the movie started pretty heavy on that whole music theme, didn't it? As if it was the one thing this movie had going for it, which is sad because, I mean, nothing against Manilow, but the music wasn't even that interesting. The whole story wasn't that interesting. Hell, even the animation seemed choppy and unfinished. That's not the Don Bluth I know. Actually, he isn't even in the credits. Because apparently, during the making of this movie, MGM kept demanding changes and Don Bluth decided to just up and leave the project, asking that his name not even show up in the credits. Wait a minute, let me get this straight. After all this time I spent making this review, I wasn't even technically covering a Don Bluth movie. Are you freaking kidding me? Well, on the plus side, the DVD came with interactive games. This is not a game.
Can you believe that the penguin is the only bird that can swim and not fly?
Well then what the fuck was your movie trying to teach me then? Is there no one in this world I can trust? Well, shit. That didn't make anything better, did it? Guess I still have a Don Bluth movie to cover. So, till next time, I guess.
If you're into pain and agony,
agony.
If you love the great indoors,
welcome to the good show.